Hello again, it's me, X2E, and welcome to a second uploading of this week's July the 16th New Music FriYay. For some reason, due to unknown issues that I have no issue of how to use YouTube, I just do videos and upload. But for some reason, it was locked. So now I'm hopefully unlocking it by re-uploading it once more. Let's hope this one works, and if it does and you like the video, feel free to do that likey and clicky thing that people, these kids, do these days. It's been a fantastic week for new music, even though it was hit with a rather big depressive stick of Radiohead. So enjoy, sit back, relax, grab a cup of tea. I've been X2E, and I'll see you next week. Good morning, one and all, and welcome to another New Music FriYay. And today, it's an extremely sunny day, and it's a wonderful day to listen to some new tunes. Now, kicking off this week's New Music FriYay is a marvellous, well, it's not really, it's a useful rendition of Dolly Parton's Jolene. Now, this is by Rockabye Baby, and if you've yet to have kids, put this one in your memory banks, because when you do have kids, they have got a whole library of classics, new stuff, modern stuff, just everything done in a lullaby style. And it does, having three kids myself, it does actually really help put them to sleep, and you get to hum along as well. So if you want to enjoy bedtimes after the bedtime story, check out Rockabye Baby. I'm X2E, and welcome to New Music FriYay. Let's see what's coming up next. Now, next up, we have Silver Lining by Tokyo Machine and The End of the World. Now, could this be The End of the World? Because it's sounding very unlike Tokyo Machine. And I'm guessing that is End of the World's influence. This geezer, though, Tokyo Machine, has been wearing masks since before it was cool or before we had to. And I'm sure he's going to continue to wear a mask and give us some fantastic tracks for years to come, if it is indeed not The End of the World. So, happy New Music Friday, check out Tokyo Machine, and introducing to myself, End of the World, and maybe it introduces to you also. Oh, if only I could really be there in the Aegean Sea, but no, I'm here virtually in the Aegean Sea. But next up, we have Bouzouki Kings with DJ Izzy-E, or Izzy-E. Anyway, this might be the little Greek in me, but I have got a fondness for Bouzouki music. Really, my papu used to blast it in the car, and I'd be sitting next to him, and he'd be there with his cumbaloi, tapping along, driving erratically, as all Greeks do. But I've since then have always had an affinity to good old Bouzouki music. And there's a lot more out there than just good old Zorba. So check out Bouzouki Kings. This probably isn't the best they've got, or the best they've done. In fact, I'm telling you, this is not the best they've done. They've done a lot better. But either way, band worth checking out if you want to smash some plates at a wedding. Hey, it's me again, X2E. Sorry about the brief pause on New Music FriYay, important phone calls and whatnot. But talking of importance, and here is Tom McDonald, the independent rap superstar. Yeah, that's what I'm going to call him, the independent rap superstar. The important thing about that was not superstar, it was independent. And being independent, he can say a lot of things that other people may not have the balls to say or the financial backing to do so. I respect the guy. He's continuing banging out some top tunes. This one called Withdrawals was a bit somber, but that was the content matter of it. So check it out if you haven't. It's like Piers Morgan and who's I keep forgetting? Catherine Ryan's Love Child. That's what I'm going to call him from now. Piers Morgan and Catherine Ryan's Love Child brings us Withdrawals by Tom McDonald. Enjoy. Happy New Day Friday. You are unforgiven. No, this is Unforgiven. A May 14th, 1991 rough mix of Metallica's Unforgiven. And I don't blame these guys for rehashing the old stuff for the new market, because everybody needs and deserves to have Metallica in their lives. Now, if you want an introduction to the masters of metal, may I please suggest the Royal Symphonic Orchestra thing they did. That album was digestible on so many levels. But if you haven't heard that one before, this is not a bad place to start either. The Black Album from Metallica, or the Rough Cuts from the Black Album from Metallica, 1991, Unforgiven.
Well, I did not see this coming, and I could not be happier. We have a metal marathon on New Music FriYay. First up, we had Metallica and the Rough Cuts of Unforgiven and their Black Album. You know, rehashing of the old stuff. But no, the metal gods have smiled upon us today and give us Iron Maiden. Now, I've been rocking out to these guys since I was 12 years old, doing a paper round with big old orange earphones and the tape deck. Either way, I am so happy to see these back again. And nobody will be disappointed, because you will have no doubt heard of these gods, Iron Maiden, and here they are with writing on the wall. So rock on, motherfuckers! I almost swore, I don't want to swear too much. Rock on, and yes, Iron Maiden! Now here's something you may not expect. It's Aqua. Now Aqua are a lot more than Barbie Girls, and you know, Dr. Jones. But they are fun. But what they truly are is musicians. Now, a lot of people will just go, nah, Aqua don't do music. But they are. They are bloody amazing musicians. They've done some fantastic classical stuff. They've done some fantastic operatic stuff. They do writing credits hidden away. You would never expect them. You'll find them. It's Aqua, musical maestros. And this is their Copenhagen 2021 somewhere. And it's called I Am What I Am. And her voice, as always, is spectacular. So if you only know Aqua for Barbie Girl, and you do dismiss them, maybe you've missed them too soon. And I suggest you try their few years back Dying Heart. Summertime vibes continue with the Summertime Genius. On Marley and the Wailers. This is called, well, you know what this is called. It's called Stir It Up. It's the Capitol Sessions from back 1973, just before I was a twinkle in my father's nuts. Either way, happy times, good music, jamming away in the sunny, sunny, yeah. This is going to come up on a lot of white people's barbecues over this weekend, I guarantee it. So check it out. Bob Marley and the Wailers from the Capitol Session 73. Stare it up, man. Stare it up. Bang this one out in 15 seconds or less. This is You and Me by Cloud Non. Another EDM journey to electronic funk. If you're talking, music has a message. Well, I do a lot because I believe music is the stories of the literate. No. That sounds derogatory. Not stories of the literature, but you know what I mean. You don't have to be able to read to understand them. Hear the messages that have been shouted out in music. And Public Enemy have been shouting the messages. See, he's telling me now, pay attention. For as long as I've been, almost as long as I've been on the planet. And here they are with the 7777 project, Rise of Rage. Right. Yeah, it might not be everyone's cup of tea. Might not be everyone's jam. Some people make the message in a more melodic way. But Public Enemy, they deserve not to have to do that anymore. They've been shouting at us for freaking years, and people just don't listen. So maybe it's time we took notes. Listen, we've just gone from music with a message, and this is music with a very different message that every father does not want to hear. Don't wait up. So this is Shakira shouting, don't wait up. And you know what Shakira is. It's a multilingual, platinum, hip-shaking superstar. And this one is just another happy go-lucky. It's an earworm. You're going to be hearing it throughout the airwaves, no doubt, over the next couple of weeks. So Don't Wait Up by Shakira. And side note, no doubt within the next couple of days, there'll be a gym, BPM, happy, let's run in the gym! Version of this, and that'd be definitely one to put on your running playlist. Next up, we have the mainstream EDM from David Guetta, Galantis, and Little Mix. Somebody else is rolling along there as well. Tachimichi? Either way, it's a mainstream EDM for a mainstream happy gym going Yeah, you're going to hear this in the gyms. You're going to hear this in the clubs, maybe. But the version here in the clubs will not be as, you know, be a bit more up-tempo. But either way, you can't ignore it. It's David Guetta. He does get about, and you've got to respect the guy for that. So, you see, after Monster Cat, this stuff just sounds flat. I'm sorry, but it does. I'm sure it'll brighten up your morning commute, but it's not. Nah, it's not my cup of tea anymore. Sorry, guys. But you might like it, and there's no shame in it. Like what you like.
Yay!
Something a little better than the last one. This is by Faint, and it's called Fading Wind. Now, this is more crisp. It's still not as up-tempo. It doesn't have to be. It's just something in this that just lifts you up. And I'm liking it. Yes. Faded Wind by Faint. I rather like this one. Here we have some country going pop. Little Big Town, Brian Christopher and Cheat Codes. It's called Never Love Again. And you may never love again, but this, you may never love this. But it is country, pop and happy. Perfect summertime vibe. Can't go wrong. Doesn't matter what genre you like. It's, you know, it's got the steps, you can hear it. You can hear that in the background. You can hear it. I can actually see it. It's going up, but it's like, yeah, it's sort of yellow and green. It just sort of mixes together and poo, little fireworks going off. See, that's what I see. Inside the mind of a madman. Anyway, this is a country pop. Little Big Town, Brian Christopher, Cheat Codes. Yeah, enjoy. Whoa, they're all crawling out the woodwork at the minute, aren't they? All these old school 90s hip-hop legends are out there remixing, rejigging and meeting up with new people. Going back to basics, you could say. Oh yeah, look, Basics by Breezy, aka Breezy, featuring Redman and Jordan Royale. It's a little nod to the old school, bringing it to the new school and kicking it in the good old days of the 90s. You know, a lot of MCing going on this. It's, I'm gonna say it's like Beastie Boy-ish. People may disagree with that one, but no, I'm feeling a bit of Beastie Boy's flavor in there. Yeah, definitely. Anyway, if you like this sort of thing, add it to your like list. I've added it to mine. It's gonna sound nice with that bass in the car. Now, if you're thinking you may recognize this song, you probably do, and you're old. It's Kenny Loggins, you know, the guy that brought us Footloose. Either way, this is a Kenny Loggins. This is an Ian Asher remix for the nows. You say it's for the nows, but listen to that piano. That's very 80s acid house. See, if they changed that voice to like some, yeah, boom, and female lead vocals, that you've got an 80s freaking acid house rave mix here. That's what it should have been called. The yellow, you know what I mean? That yellow is just a big smiley face behind of it, and yeah, 80s acid house remix. But no, it's for now. So yay, acid. Am I strong enough to be your man? Probably not. I'm as weak as wet paper. But either way, it is strong enough to be your man. I haven't heard this song since the original album came out. And you know what? I really like it. And I even like this version even more. It's just so laid back than even the original version from the 96, 97, or 98. Or was it early 2000? I don't know. I'm getting old, you know. But either way, I'm glad to hear this back in new music. FriYay. And it's a live version. I keep breaking my own rules by putting a live version in the car, but the crowd noise isn't quite as annoying as it normally is. So yeah, introduction to Sheryl Crow. You know who she is. If you don't, check her out. You know, more country version of Shania Twain. It's always a surprise when you hear some classical classics in new music FriYay lineup. And you know, I think it's a pleasant surprise, and you might too. Also,
And here has an Inpolka, Op 117. I mean, they didn't really name them very catchy back then, did they? Either way, it's the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra playing the Strauss family, the greatest last night of the proms. Classical music in new music. What a lineup, eh? What a lineup. I feel like I should put a hat on and drink a cup of tea. Do you think Sia can see? Or if she's an actual seer? Either way, she's been knocking about now for a few years. Her voice is very powerful and nice to listen to. Never actually heard anything terrible by her. And it always ends up in my like playlist. So maybe I'm a Sia fan after all. Ooh, we'll have to see about that. Anyway, it's 1 + 1. Now, as my 5-year-old will tell you, that's 2! But he'd be really excited when he said it. So here we go, 1 by 1 by Sia. And our Banks and Ranks. We're all hardwired to something. And this is Hardwired by Shock One and Rachel Lee. It's good. Don't take my word for it. Seek it out on Spotify or Apple Music. Or go out to a music store. We still have them. I mean, Runcorn actually still hasn't. Is it Runcorn? No. No. Warrington has a rather nice little HMV. And Liverpool one did have a HMV, but now that's closed and open somewhere else. Williamson Square soon. But either way, we do still have record stores, and you can still buy vinyl for the hipsters, and you can buy CDs. You know, those things that, like, they're about this big. Yeah. Either way, Hardwired. This would be nice on vinyl, actually. God, I'm showing the beard, aren't I? Yeah. Play this loud. I may get a lot of flack for this. Probably not too much flack, because not a lot of people actually watch these videos. But those that do, mate, they suddenly not watch any more of my videos ever again. Because I'm going to say it. I freaking hate this song. I really hate it. And if I could delete it from the entire musical history, it would be gone. No. And, you know, that's, I could be bitter, because I've sadly know quite a few people that have lost their or ended their own lives. And this, at the time when this song was in its first resurgence, and I might not have been in a place to hear such melancholy, tripe, emotional. So I'm going to end this video by saying, if you are one of those people and you are ever contemplating that, please seek out help. If anything, to avoid people having to be subjected to this music and start crying, you know, there's help out there. Stay safe, man.
Oh God, it's still going. 9 minutes long. I can't think of anything worse. Well, I can think of a lot of things worse, to be honest. So while this is still waffling on, trying to like make us all, oh no. I'm on a serious note, I will say, if you do need to seek help, like I did at the end of this video, please, it is out there, and something that has helped me a lot in my own times of crisis has been Calm, the campaign for against living miserably. They do web chat and they do phone calls, and I put the phone number on the last post, and I'm going to say it again. It's an 0800 number, and it's 0800 58 58 58. And if you're a man and you do need to seek help, this is definitely a place worth turning to. They will help you, but not this. Please don't listen to this song.
Well, after the last song, anything would have cheered the mood up. But I'm glad it's been country music, because that's another saviour in your time of need. Can turn to country any old time. Good old country music. It's guaranteed to get you through. And this is Zac Brown Band, and it's an old love song. Yeah, an old love song. I was hoping for something a little bit more upbeat and happier after the tremendous 9 minutes of creep. But I'm happy this is good enough. So, yeah. If you want to foray into the newborn of a new country, can't go wrong with Zac Brown Band. Yes, thank you, Zac. Thank you. Time is ticking against me, so I'm doing this quickly. 15 seconds or less. Uncharted Waters by the great Shingo Nakamura. Monster Cat, it's a bad kitty, but a good tune. Have I got time for this? Well, I'm squeezing it in anyway. This is Keizo and Parish Shadows. It's called Poison. And Keizo, yes,
He's back on the road again. Sadly, nowhere near me. But then why would he come to this horrible little island? No, he's going to nicer places than this. But he's going to be bringing a show, let me tell you. He is amazing live. He can bring down the roof of a non-roofed, unroofed, open-roof stadium. He is... boom! It's Kazo. Paired him up with Gamma, and you've just got the best bass drops on the planet. You know, that is an ideal. That would be ideal, wouldn't it? Kazo and Gamma, a night of them. Yeah, it takes a few weeks to recover from that. Anyway, this is Poison, Kazo, Power of Shadows. Check out Kazo if you're lucky enough to be in one of his many destinations. He's back. In fact, he posted. He's on a plane. He's on the way. Yay! Well, what a roller coaster it has been. This week's New Music Friday, or FriYay, has brought us some amazing tunes from Metal Gods to country and western legends, but sadly it also brought us back to Creep. And not only did he think of bringing it back, he brought it back for 9 minutes, and that's three videos I've moaned about this. So I'm going to end today on a high with Monster Cat, Call of the Wild, episode 357 with Morelli and Aralyn Marin. And there's a lot of chord changing in here. There's also a lot of happy EDM. And if you have been listening, if you've been affected by anything in this week's New Music Friday, please get the help you need. And if you just want to be happy and enjoy this weekend in the sun, bang some Monster Cat on there. Happy times ahead. Can't get any.